Rabbi say, what is any tikkun de tzibur without the seeker matrei shir tikkun de tzibur bekriyas haTorah?
There's no doubt tikkun tzibur is a very serious problem. So many halachas are impacted by this tikkun de tzibur. Some consider it a deraisa, al tzar ba lechayim, al tzar b'yach kemoicha. We suggested the pasuk tokum v'yadarta, but the person has to realize that this is something that really should affect the way we treat a tzibur. It's not just a minute, it's a minute times the tzibur's amount, and time is life, time is more than olam haba, time is life itself, and tikkun tzibur is very precious. But the way it comes, what we saw from a Mishnah in Yuma, that they allowed to lay in the maftir bal peh, because he couldn't mish, because then the tzibur's mitzapim v'doimimim. We saw the source also from the Gemara in Saita, that you take the Sefer Torah out and you take the coverings later. A third source from the Mishnah that you take out three Sefer Torah and you don't miss the first one, but you can't keep a tzibur waiting. The Rashba says that even though the Kayin should get Kayin, but if he's not yet holding by laying, he's still davening Berchus Krishma or Tuk Zimra, you're not to wait for him. We don't lay every day, even though Mar B'Torah, Mar B'Chayim, Al Tirkha de Tziburah. There's no Aisafas during the week on a Monday and Thursday, period, even if you have Chiyuvim, Al Tirkha de Tziburah. The Minig is to only make one Hagba, even though it would make sense to make a Hagba before and afterwards, we only do one Al Tirkha de Tziburah. How do you call up the Oila to the Torah? You call him by name, or go to him and tell him to come. The different Minhagim, Ashkenaz and Svard, are both based on the concept of avoiding Tirkha de Tziburah. A Balkaira, that's the only Balkaira in Shul, that's in the middle of either Psukha de Zimra or even Birchas Krishma, to prevent Tirkha de Tziburah, he's allowed to lane, and he overlooks the possible hefsik of laning in the middle of davening, because Tirkha de Tziburah overrides that. The changing of Balkaira in the middle of a laning is okay if it's needed for the Kavara Tzibur. He doesn't have to hear the brachas necessarily. You're allowed to correct any mistake, as long as you don't embarrass the person, but you're allowed to correct any mistake, because that's part of the job, to make sure that it's laying properly, and it's not Tirkha de Tziburah. If Lamaisa took out the wrong Sefer Torah, some will use it as it is and miss it, because we're Chayshiv Pagam. Some would put it back, because we're Chayshiv Kvayra Tzibur. If you just took it out, you could put it right back, or if you have two Sefer Torah and you put down the Maftir, instead of putting down the Chayva Sayyim, so then you're allowed to change it, because Lachkula Alma, there's no Pagam when you're laning from both Sefer Torah anyhow. It's a b'chesed that the Gabbai should be around, or at least make it clear which is which Torah, not to cause b'zyonis for the Oila, for the Baal Psicha, and not to cause a mistake in the wrong Sefer Torah. When there's a big Oila, so the minig is either one person makes it as Moshe the Tzibur, or as someone added, everybody says it together, b'vasachas, and you could say amen to all the brachas together, but to have each one say would be Tirkha de Tziburah. The Balkaira should not lane too fast or too slow. It should be lane in a pleasant way to bring out the ne'imus of our Torah. After the Hagbah, you're allowed to start Yiratzin right away, or even Ashevah Otzin right away, because it's only a minig, and it doesn't justify keeping the Tziburah waiting until you finish the Hagbah Galilah. It's only on Shabbos that you have to wait until the Galilah is finished before you start the Haftarah, and that one of the main reasons is I was covered for the Torah, not to mix Torah and Navi. The minig in most places that you keep the Sefer Torah open for the first bracha of the Aliyah, either look straight ahead and close your eyes, or look to the side. Some Mukubalim and some Chassidim close the Sefer Torah, like the minig of the Rizal, but Pashit, the reason why we don't close the Sefer Torah is Tirkha de Tziburah, even though it's a very, very short amount of time. Some, the halacha, how to go to the aliyah is the quickest way possible, even if it means turning left. If you go right and you get there quickly that way, of course, then you minus first. But the going quickly and avoiding tirkha tibur is more important than going to the yamin. If a tibur missed a whole parsha, they have to make it up. If they can make it up this Shabbos by mincha and it's not a great tirkha tibur, that would be better. If not, make it up next week, and that's not Tirkha Tziburah if you're doing the halacha. If you only have one Sefer Torah and you have to have two or three kriyas, avad, you have to mish. That's not a justification to give up laning for Tirkha Tziburah, because the chiv has to be done. We saw the Hezbo of the Mordechai, the Ritva, that is only in the Beis HaMikdash where the third kriya was not a real chiyuv, then you lay in alpeh. There are some shuls that never make kaisafis, and there's a reason alpeh halacha not to make kaisafis, maybe because maybe it's a question of bracha shein etzricha. The minig in most places to make kaisafis, but it has to be done with a sensitivity, not to make too many kaisafis, because that is really a great tircha de tziburim. The mishaberachs, the long mishaberachs, are really tircha de tzibur. They should be minimized or keep it to no mishaberach, like many shuls do have. But basically, we have to think of a tzibur, not just our own needs. You found a mistake in the Sefer Torah, so you change the Sefer Torah. And if you make a safas anyhow, so it's kedai to make seven aliyahs in the new Sefer Torah. But l'chayr, if your minig is not to make any safas, so then you finish laning in the new Sefer Torah as if it would be a continuation of the old laning. The minig is take two or three Sefer Torah together, even though it's a shtickle bezoin of the Sefer Torah. But apparently the covet of the tzibur, the tircha tzibura, justifies taking them out together, two or three. The minig is to take out two Sefer Torah of Parshas Kolam, even though it's probably shorter to take out one, but Kvana Hagu Kein, those that have a minig only one, Avada, we understand why. We don't start the brachas of the Haftarah until the Galila has completed his job. That's the Gemara, and there are a few reasons for that. Either it's Kavod HaTorah, or else he shouldn't miss even the beginning of the Haftarah. I forgot to mention, the Shaar Ephraim says, even if in a shul that they don't learn the Haftarah, and each person learns a mechumish, so there's no chshash of missing Haftarah, still wait to start out the reasons of Kavod HaTorah, out the chshivas of the Torah. You could wait for a klaf, because that's your minik, so that's your chiyuv. And the last question, when you have to make psicha, bring the Sefer Torah back, and the tziba has to wait until he comes back to say kaddish and start Shemayin Esra, that's a big tzarachin, if that's justifiable. Maybe you should think about Kvayra Tzibur and not wait for the Yachid and assume that this is not a case that you have to wait for him because it's the makam of Kvayra Tzibur. That will leave it at Tzarachim.